In the last episode, our undercover journalist described the overcrowding, poor hygiene, food, and living conditions in the hostel under the nose of police and civil leaders. When it appeared that the neighborhood became suspicious, the Arab shifted the girls to another place. The girls were told they would leave any time and, in fact, instructed to come with just two dresses. But a month was about to elapse. They were not allowed to leave, and anyone caught absent would be expelled and travel papers cancelled. The conditions were bad. Loss of freedom, poor feeding, poor hygiene, lack of amenities, and growing frustration was the order of the day. Our undercover journalist got used to tears at the hostel. Everyone had her own story, and girls would break down during the narration. For Mina, her story is sad. This young girl in her mid-20s was married with three children back in Busoga. In her narration, her husband was a taxi driver. She was a tailor back in her village. She narrated that after her husband got an accident, she was left responsible for him and the children. The sewing machine could not do much. They both agreed that she goes to Saudi so she could support the family. Her sister linked her to Florence and Richard, who were her agents. She did not have a passport then, so Florence asked her to get 550,000 shillings for the passport. Mina did not have money, but had a plot in Busoga, which she had bought 3 million shillings with her mother's support. Because she was promised to start a process and go in 2 weeks, she borrowed 550,000 shillings with a collateral of a plot of land worth 3 million in an agreement that after a month, she would return 600,000 shillings when working. Even after being convinced by Florence, she asked her to sell her sewing machine after being convinced how she did not have much time in Uganda. This was common in many girls at the company being told to abandon their businesses by their agents on promise that they would travel in less than 2 weeks. Mina had spent close to 6 months at the hostel. Florence took her money and did not take on time as promised. The owner of the money took the plot of land because there was an agreement. She lost her plot and almost lost her marriage, as the husband could not believe her story. She finally went after a big hassle. It wasn't only Mina with a sad story. Another girl disclosed how she was servicing a bank loan of 1.5 million shillings when her husband abandoned her with two children. She decided to take her children to her parents and got recruited in one of the recruitment agencies in Mengo in April last year. Months before she traveled, the company's license was suspended by the ministry and everyone was ordered to go back home. There were no cooks in the hostel. The girls were formed into teams and each had a turn to cook and clean dishes. So food quality was never good because no one was paid for the labor. Food would either be burnt or unready. One time, girls asked the Arab bosses to hire cooks and they overreacted about it, telling them that if they cannot cook here, what would they be going to do in Saudi Arabia? That day, girls almost rioted due to poor food. Our undercover journalist arrived on the 16th of August 2021 and 3 days later, they were told that all would shift to a new place. Rumors came saying the landlord had ordered them to leave after being shocked by the numbers. Ahmed blamed the eviction on the girls. He said some girls had gotten used to the neighborhood and started jumping over the perimeter wall to look for men, alcohol, or escape back home. The girls were only allowed to leave the premises for medical reasons. But according to Matron Harriet, the house belongs to one of the senior lecturers at Makerere University and had rented it for 6 months at 3 million shillings per month. But the landlord discovered the premises were being mismanaged and local leaders were overwhelmed by complaints from neighbors about noise. There was not much to prepare to live with. The girls were ferried away in a mini truck, beds and mattresses. Our undercover journalist was told to stay with another colleague because they had not done medicals. The rest were hurriedly boarded on a mini truck on top of the mattresses while Arabs were driven away. She stayed with Matron Harriet, her daughter Gloria, Christine, and one Arab called Majid, who was sleeping in one of the rooms. To start the process of going, they were then taken for a medical. The Gulf Cooperation Council, GCC, is a medical examination done on migrant workers traveling to work in the six Gulf countries of Kuwait, Bahrain, Oman, Qatar, Saudi Arabia, and United Arab Emirates. Abdul Karim, one of the staff, said medical costs $70. You book online and each is allocated to specific hospital. They include Medicare Kampala Diagnostic Center, JB Clinic in Kabalagala, Carlson Medical Services, Medical World, City Medicals, and Jeolo in Bugorobi, City Ambulance, among others. Our undercover journalist was sent to Medicare Kampala Diagnostic Center based in Bukoto on Kiro Road on August 24th around 1:15 p.m. When results are out, they were shared online, but girls were told by office because they were not supposed to go back to the hospital. We discovered that some girls failed the medical and were asked for money to have their results changed to good. One of her colleagues, Rahma, confirmed that a nurse at Medicare asked her for money to give her favorable results. That a nurse called them outside and said their blood pressure was high. She demanded for 100,000 shillings to record a good result. They gave her 20,000 shillings and she refused. She told them there was no free service since they were traveling to make money. In the next episode, we bring to you village flights, sex, mega scam, pregnancies, protests, and move to close the hostel.